Hey guys, it's Hadi, and in this video I'm going to teach you how to illuminate an exterior scene with the Vray sun and sky. But before we start, please take a moment and subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future tutorials. Now let's move over to 3dsmax and start the project. Okay, I've chosen this building for this tutorial, which is called Niceto Vega, located in Buenos Aires, Argentina. I've put the link into its Arch Daily page in the description if you want to know more about it. Okay, to start, I'm going to set up the render settings. In the comment tab, we have nothing but the size, and I've already changed that when I was setting up the cameras. So let's go to the V-ray tab and start by adding a V-ray material as our override material. And I'm also going to disable the displacement so it will render faster. As for the image sampler, I'm going to use the progressive, but let's increase the noise threshold's number up to 0.3. For the color mapping, I'm going to use the default Reinhardt, and I'm going to reduce the burn value down to 0.2. Okay, as for the GI, I'm going to use the default engines, Brute Force and Light Cache. There's nothing to change here, but let's just decrease the subdiv's value down to 500. We don't need to change anything in the settings and the elements tab, so we're ready to start. Okay, let's start the interactive rendering to see what we have so far. As you can see, our render is completely black, and that's because we don't have any light sources in the scene. So let's go to the create panel and select the V-ray sun under the V-ray section and start adding the sun into the scene from the top view. Here, V-ray will ask you if you want to use the V-ray sky as your environment light, and since that is our goal, let's just hit OK and see the result. Okay, the next step is to move the sun up along the z-axis. Let's go to the front view and move it all the way up to here. As you can see, the render is overexposed. There are two ways that you can fix that. The first one is to reduce the intensity on both V-ray sky and V-ray sun, which is not my preferred way. But anyway, this is how you can do it. First, open up the environment and effects window and drag and drop the V-ray sky into the material editor. And make sure to choose instance here. Now double click on the map and enable this option over here. Then click here and select your V-ray sun. Now you're able to change all the parameters of the V-ray sky regardless of V-ray sun. But instead of changing the intensity, I'm going to decrease the exposure through my camera settings. Let's select the camera from here and reduce the exposure by increasing the target exposure value. I'm going to use 12 for this render. It's still a little bit brighter than it needs to be, and that's because we still have no materials in the scene. So I'm going to keep it as 12, and I will change it later if necessary. Okay, we have a new sky model in the V-ray5, and you can find it here. This one. This new sky system is looking so much more realistic in terms of color and intensity. It also supports some below the horizon line, which means that from now on you can have the night sky in V-Ray, which is perfect. Okay, one of the most important parts of rendering is shadows. To find the best angle for your sunlight, you can easily move the sun around as interactive render is running. It'll be different from scene to scene, and it is you who has to decide which angle is more suitable for your project. As you can see, these shadows are too sharp. If you want to get softer shadows, all you need to do is to first select the V-ray sun and then increase its size from here. Okay, look what happens when I increase this number up to 5. All of the shadows are softer now, but it is up to you whether you want to increase or decrease it. I'm going to use 2.5 for this render. The other thing is that you can simulate different hours of the day by moving the sun along the z-axis. For example, I could simulate the sunset if I move it down to here. After moving the sun, if you feel your render is over or underexposed, you can once again adjust the target exposure value in the camera settings. Now let's add some contrast to this render. I'm going to add a curves adjustment from here and add some contrast to the shadows by making an S-shaped curve like this. If you want your shadows to be darker or brighter, you can change the intensity on the V-ray sky also. Increasing the intensity makes the shadows brighter and decreasing it makes them darker. I'm going to leave it at 1 because I'm happy with the result. Once again, let's look at the differences between the improved sky system and this one. Look how different the colors are. I totally like the improved one better. Alright, let's check one of the other cameras. Once again, to change the intensity, we just need to increase the target exposure value. I'm gonna use 11 for this camera. For this depth of field effect, all you have to do is to enable this option over here and change the aperture. I'll tell you all about it in one of my next videos. Okay, I'm gonna change the sun's position to where it was before and render this shot, and I will get back to you when it's done. Okay guys, this is the final image without any adjustment layers, and as you can see, it doesn't have enough contrast and it looks a little bit dull. So the first step is to add some contrast to this image by using a curves adjustment. So you need to simply click here and select the curves. Now let's make the shadows a bit darker by moving this handle down a bit, and let's make the highlights a bit brighter. Now to get rid of the burned out areas, we can simply add an exposure adjustment layer and slightly reduce the highlight burn value. Okay, let's add a color balance layer and add a little bit of bluish tint to the shadows and maybe a little bit of yellow to the midtones. Now as for the last step, I'm going to use a lookup table layer and use one of my favorite LUT files, which comes with Corona Renderer. Just make sure to disable convert to sRGB space first, and let's decrease the opacity for a tiny bit, and we're done. Okay, this is a good base for us to export it to Photoshop and do some post-production to make it pop a little bit more. Alright guys, thank you for being with me during this tutorial. Please give it a thumbs up if you find it useful, and do not forget to subscribe to the channel. See you next time.